snakes. Yeah, you don't know about them. God gonna tell you about them. Watch this.
Titus chapter 1 verse 9.
Bring it out.
Holding fast the faithful word as he has been taught, that he may be able by sound doctrine both to exhort and to convince the gainsayers.
By sound doctrine, we are supposed to be to convince the gainsayers, the people who come against this Bible, by using sound doctrine, which is God's commandments, God's words. We're supposed to convince. That's what the pastor's supposed to be doing. Read.
For there are many unruly and vain talkers and deceivers, especially they of the circumcision.
Because it's a lot of people claiming to be pastors of the flock. They're what?
They are vain talkers and deceivers, especially they of the circumcision.
Especially of our people. They vain talkers and deceivers, like telling you that God said he needs 10% of your money. What God needs some money for? Is tithing 10% of money? Where in the Bible can we read that tithing is 10% of money? It ain't in there. But I know. But they use scriptures to say, will a man rob God? Because all we know is corner thinking, and we think money. We don't never think it's taking care of our people.
Right.
You rob God by not giving your portion to your nation.
Right.
Well, I realized that when Potter's house.
You got to pay to get in there. You got to pay to get in that thing. They got ATM at the front door, don't
you? You got to pay to get into the church.
They got bouncers, too?
I heard they got guns and everything.
Say, man, that sound like club.
That's what I heard.
What'd you say, club Potter's house? That sound like club Potter's house to me. Watch this.
Whose mouths must be stopped.
God said them pastors that teach that, their mouths must be stopped. And you stop it by giving your people sound doctrine. Because when you know the truth now, whenever he say something, you like, that ain't what the Bible say.
Right.
Because I read that, somebody gave me the understanding on that, and that ain't what the Bible talking about. You made that up. You know what I'm saying? You defend against it with sound doctrine. Read.
Who subvert whole houses.
And subvert whole houses. They teach women, thou art loosed. Woman, you supposed to be an obedient to your husband.
That's right.
That's what God said. That's why Eve was plagued with birth pains, with labor pains, for not listening to her husband.
Right.
So how in the hell you loosed from your husband? That's what America teaches. That's not what God teaches.
Right.
That's what the white man teaches. That's not what God teaches. But the white man teach these pastors that we got in Christianity, Baptist, Catholicism, even going into some of these other religions. Where they say the goddess Esther, when you worship the woman. The women are not being worshipped in this Bible. God is.
Right.
Read.
Teaching things which they ought not, for filthy lucre's sake.
Why do they lie and deceive the people?
For filthy lucre's sake.
Because they want that money. They want that paper. So they'll tell you whatever feel good to you, so you can dig deeper and deeper in your pockets and fill up the collection plate.
That's right.
I'll praise to the Most High. But give me Hebrews 10:25. You don't go to that church, but whether you do it for your spirit. You don't go to no church. Watch this.
Hebrews chapter 10 and verse 25. Not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together, as the manner of some is.
You cannot forsake assembling with your people. You know that you're an Israelite. Have anybody showed you that you're an Israelite? Give me Deuteronomy 28. Because you cannot forsake the assembling with your people. Alright? But you have to know who your people are, and you have to know where you fit in. Alright? Read 28:15.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
Let's paint the picture. Alright? Give me Deuteronomy 1:1. We got to paint the picture to give you to visually show you what's happening in this in the book of Deuteronomy, okay? Watch.
Deuteronomy chapter 1 and verse 1.
Bring it out.
These be the words which Moses spake to all Israel on this side of Jordan in the wilderness.
In the what?
In the wilderness.
So this is Moses speaking to all the Israelites in the wilderness. This is right after God destroyed the Egyptians and killed the Egyptians for the Israelites to come out of slavery in Egypt. Alright? So now they in the wilderness. Moses is the lead, the head, God, he's the mediator between the Israelites and God in the wilderness. Moses is called up on Mount Sinai. Right? He spent 40 days and 40 nights up there with God. When he came down and stood up in front of everybody, give me verse 15, this is what he said.
Deuteronomy 28 and verse 15.
Bring it out.
But it shall come to pass, if thou would not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
He said, it's going to happen. If y'all don't listen to God,
to observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes.
If you don't observe and recognize and put into action these commandments,
which I command you this day,
which is God, because Moses is the mouth of God, command you this day,
that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
He said, curses gonna come upon who? Who is he talking to?
The black people.
Who is he talking to?
The tribe of Judah.
He talking to who? Read verse 21. Read.
These be the words which Moses spake to all Israel.
Who is he talking to? All Israel. Because it's closed-minded to think our people are not light-skinned. We got people that range in all different colors.
That's right.
Because being an Israelite is not according to your skin, it's your seed.
Right.
You understand? Because you might lay down and have a baby with a woman from another nation. But if you are from the tribe of Judah, your child still from the tribe of Judah.
Right, that's right.
You know what I'm saying? And your child might be light-skinned. But that don't mean that your child is not an Israelite.
Right.
You understand? You're an Israelite by the seed.
That's right.
Not by the spirit, not by the color. Because there's some black people who devils right out here today. You understand? Read.
Deuteronomy 28 and verse 16. Cursed shall thou be in the city, and cursed shall thou be in the field.
God said, you Israelites, y'all gonna be cursed in the city and cursed in the field. Answer this for me, bro. Where do black people live? The majority of black people live in all the cities in the world, across the world. What part of the cities are we located in?
Low poverty
areas, ghettos, barrios, reservations. God said we was gonna be cursed in the city and cursed in the field. What was we doing on that picture? Point out that picture for me so both of y'all can see. That picture right there. Now go down.
Right
over one more time. Right there. What were we doing right there?
Picking cotton.
What?
Picking cotton.
Did Chinese people do that? Did Arab people do that? Did white people do that? God said, the Israelites, y'all gonna be cursed in the city and cursed in the field. We were cursed to cotton fields. We were cursed to picking sugar cane. We were cursed to pick. Even today, our brothers, the so-called Mexicans, which are the tribe of Issachar, you can catch them in the field picking strawberries, oranges. Still to this day, for less than minimum wage. Slavery, still to this day.
That's right.
You understand? Give me verse 32.
Deuteronomy 28 and verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people, and thy eyes shall look and fail with longing for them all the day long.
He said, your sons and your daughters will be given to another people. When did that happen? You see this? What is this?
Joy.
Which one here? What is that? What's happening in that picture?
Slave auctions.
That's auctions, right. Slave blocks.
That's right.
Was Chinese people being given away on those auction slave blocks? Huh? Was Arab people being given away on auction? auction slave blocks? There's a white man being given away on an auction slave block.
Bring it up.
Who is this talking about?
Black.
No, no.
Israelite.
There you go.
Right.
It's talking about the 12 tribes of Israel. God said to Moses, tell these people, if they don't keep my commandments, they're going to get sold on oxen slave blocks. They're going to be working in the cotton field. Let's finish that up. And there shall be no might in thy hand. It ain't nothing you can do about it when your kids being given away.
Right.
What can we do? When the slave master sold your son off to another master, to another plantation, what could you do? Was you whipping butt all over the place?
I would have been another Nat Turner.
You say you would have, huh?
I
would have
been another Nat Turner.
God said they're going to be what?
Another Nat Turner.
And there shall be no might in thine hand.
That's what God said. Now you trying to tell me you more powerful than God. Because God said what?
I'm talking about.
There shall be no might in thine hand.
God said you ain't going to do nothing.
Right.
Right.
You ain't gonna do nothing but sit there and take it.
That's right.
He took your power from you.
Nat Turner
tried. Harriet Tubman tried. They all died.
That's right.
No might in your hand.
That's right.
Yeah, you is a god on this earth, but I'm gonna take your might.
That's right.
God.
Right.
Until you come back and do what the resume of a god is supposed to be doing.
That's right.
Read.
Keep going.
Verse 33. The fruit of thy land and all thy labors shall a nation which thou knowest not eat up.
Colonialism. Your people have been colonized. Another nation take your natural resources and make you pay for it. Water fall naturally from the sky.
That's right.
But if you collect it, you're going to have a fine, and they're going to put handcuffs on them, and you write their loose theory.
That's
right. Ain't no might in your hand.
That's right.
God. We have to wake up to who we are before God can give us our power back.
Yes,
that's the only way. When we do what our Father tells us to do, that's the only way we're going to have power. When we all come together, give me that Ephesians 4. Ephesians 4 and 4. Read that. When we got to put aside our differences.
Right.
Quit being selfish. You have a whole nation of women and children that look up to you to be a shining example.
Right.
A shining light to our people. Quit thinking about yourself. Read.
Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 4. There is one body and one spirit, even as ye are called, and one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism.
Read.
One God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in you all.
It's only one. That means we have to move as one, worshiping one God, not Caesar Bow.
That's right.
Not Buddha. It's one God, 1 Corinthians 1:10. And by being one God, he has one commandment. This Holy Bible is the words of God that we all supposed to be in the same mind.
That's right.
This is how we all come in the same agreement.
Right.
We read these scriptures, we agree to this is our constitution.
Right.
When we all in agreement with this, we all work in one mind and one accord. Read
1 Corinthians 1:10.
Bring it out.
Now I beseech you, brethren, by the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that you all speak the same thing.
How can we all speak the same thing? We have to know what God said, and then we're going to regurgitate what God said, and this is what this is the standard of life that you're supposed to have.
That's right.
We all going to speak the same thing. We will all have the same judgment. If a man sleep with your wife, we all going to say, that man need to be put to death.
Yes.
So nobody else will do that. Now that makes sure, that ensures that you can not leave the house with your brother at the house, knowing for certain that your brother ain't gonna sleep with your wife behind your back.
That's right.
Cause we all speak the same thing.
Right.
And when we bow here on earth, God gonna bow, he gonna make it righteous up in heaven.
That's right.
You understand that? We all agree and we say, that brother deserves to die for sleeping with that man's wife. That's the law. That's what it said. Guess what's gonna happen? Death to that brother. Now everybody else that know he committed fornication, adultery with your wife, they gonna see him get put to death. Now that put fear in everybody else.
That's right.
These are the laws that we left. Cause now in the hood, what we doing? listening to that. We don't, as a nation, I'm not talking about individually, and some things you might be better than other brothers. But for the most part, as a nation of people, we suffer because we don't do it.
That's right.
We're not living by our constitution. You are the Israelite that God is talking about. Give me Deuteronomy 28 and 68. Because I want to make sure that you know who you are. Have it registered yet? Who you are? Yeah. This is you. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 68.
Bring it out.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
What were the Israelites doing in Egypt?
Slaves.
They were slaves. God said, I'm going to bring you into slavery. With ships.
Read it again.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
Uh-huh.
By the way whereof I spake unto thee.
So this is Moses talking. He said, God said, y'all will go into slavery again on slave ships. The same way I'm telling y'all it's going to happen. This is Moses. That's how he did what he's saying. Read.
Thou shalt see it no more again.
Uh-huh. And thou shalt... You will never see your heritage, your nationality, your homeland, God's laws no more again.
That's right.
Rick, tell me when the last time you've been back to Jerusalem. Don't that fit you, bro? When have you been to Jerusalem?
I went to the Hajj, bro. I went to Mecca last year. I'm a veteran soldier in the United States Army.
Our presence to the Most High. Did Christ, because Christ said he gonna take us back to the homeland.
Right.
Did Christ take you over there? Did Christ take you?
No, my God.
So we the Israelites.
Wow.
Yeah, your job took you. But Christ said when he come, he gonna put the Israelites back in their homeland.
That's right.
Restore us back as the top nation on the earth.
That's right.
Right?
And there.
That place that y'all gonna be on them slave ships, when you get off them ships, and there, spell it there.
T-H-E-R-E.
That's a place. And there.
Ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
He said, when you get off them ships in that place, you're gonna be sold to your enemies.
Talking about over here in America.
Talking about here in America. Right. He was talking about over in Mecca. China, because the Arabians had us on slave ships in Mecca.
That's right.
But not on slave ships, but they sold us on auction blocks. They sold us on auction blocks all over the world. We were scattered. But read that. Give me verse 64.
And the Lord shall scatter thee among all people from the one end of the earth even unto the other.
He said, the Lord said, I'm going to scatter you from one end of the earth even to the other. He called us scattered. When you start reading in the New Testament, it calls us the dispersed. The dispersed living among the Gentiles.
That's right.
We are the dispersed living among the Gentiles. Do you understand? Because a lot of people, they lose focus when you get to the New Testament. The New Testament saying the same thing the Old Testament said. It's just using different words to mean the same thing.
Right.
In the Old Testament, it says scattered. In the New Testament, it says dispersed.
That's right.
It's still talking about the Israelites.
That's right.
It ain't added nobody else to our covenant.
Right.
It's so hard to serve God. And why when I say that I'm a Jew, it's our art. For years I've been walking around saying that I'm a black man. I ain't singing that no more, it sounds wrong, man.
This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.